Hey, good morning, good evening guys. Can you all hear me? S.N. Bhaskar, Sundar, Sridhar, Gautam, can you all hear me? Can you guys hear me? Okay, so welcome to this webinar. This webinar is going to be on the use of predictive analytics for e-commerce. This is actually going to be the demo part where we will show you the use of predictive analytics on e-commerce. We will broadly talk about what is advanced predictive modeling and what is Edureka has to offer to you in this course. Okay, before starting my presentation, I just want to have a quick understanding about the audience. So how I want to understand about you is I want you to, you know, score yourself on the rating of 0 to 5. 0 means you don't know anything about analytics, and 5 being you have implemented at least one analytical model. Okay, so I want each one of you to score yourself from 0 to 5. 0 being no knowledge related to analytics, 5 being you have implemented at least one analytical model in your projects. Okay, so can you please quickly do that? Okay, I have got the rating from 4 participants so far. Quickly guys, can we do that? This webinar is for just 1 hour, so I want you to be a little quick, and please feel free to use your chat panel in order to ask a question to me. Yeah, so okay, quickly guys, Ashutosh, Asif. So the guys, those who have joined just now, I want you to rate yourself from 0 to 5 based on your analytical skills, 0 being no knowledge related to analytics, and 5 means you have implemented at least one analytical model irrespective of any programming language. Asif, okay. Asif, I want you to rate from 0 to 5. Most of the people are joining just now. I again need to repeat my question. I want you to rate yourself from 0 to 5 on your analytical skills, 0 being no knowledge of analytics, 5 being you have implemented at least one model. Most of the guys I am seeing, they have the rating less than 2.5. So far I have around 8 ratings in front of me. Quickly guys, quickly, so that I can, you know, plan my presentation. I can, you know, come down to your level and can explain what is there in this course for you. Okay, good. So looks like most of us are having very, very elementary knowledge related to analytics. Right. So let me just introduce myself. My name is Ansh, and I am associated with Edureka from more than 2.5 years now. I have more than 10 years of industry experience of analytics. I have worked for several domain like insurance, energy and utility, heavy machinery, and retail and cloud analytics. So yeah, I have worked with lot many industry, and currently I am pursuing, and I'm you know building, I'm using R to build the predictive models for my clients, right? So this is a brief about myself. I am a very senior faculty of Edureka especially for R analytics, right? Guys, do you also want to set up some expectation related to this session? Quickly, if anyone, any specific expectation that you have from this session. In this session, I am going to explain you what Edureka has to offer in the course of advanced predictive modeling in R and why you should take up this course, right? And I'll also show you a quick demonstration that how we can use R to do analytics in e-commerce. Right, this is what I have in my bucket to share with you in this 1 hour. Apart from this, anyone who is having any expectation, please feel free to use your chat panel and post the question. I am having a continuous watch on the questions that are coming to me. Okay. Some question I will take right away, some question I'll take after the class, and some session will be answered during the session. Right? But anyways, your questions will certainly be answered during the session. Okay. Good. So while you are typing a question, I want to understand that, guys, what do you think? What is predictive analytics? What is predictive analytics? Predictive analytics is nothing but when you are trying to understand the data, you are trying to discover the pattern from the data which you think would not exist in the data. You are trying to get insight from the data and you are trying to forecast something based on the data, right? Let's take example of telecom. Telecom industry, they might be interested to know about what is going to be the uses of my subscriber in next 2 months, in next 3 months, in next 4 months. Who all subscriber are going to quit my system? Okay, this is from the angle of a telecom user, right? This is just the one use case. Okay, retailer might be interested to know that what is the combination of product that I should sell, I should give discount on, right? A banker may be interested to know what is the risk associated to the loan, right? Let's say if I am issuing a loan to a person XYZ, then what is the risk associated with the loan, right? Credit card company, they might be interested to know how to fix the credit limit of a particular of an individual, right? Airline industry, they might be interested to know that how they can optimize the flight schedule, how they can optimally use the runway, right? So these are couple of examples from various industries where we can use analytics, right? Is my voice clear? Asif is saying my voice is breaking. Is it breaking for all of you or is it clear? Is it breaking my voice? Yeah, it's clear. Okay, good. Thanks, Deepak. Right, so what we are going to do in this session is we are going to know what is predictive analytics, application of predictive analytics, how organizations are using predictive analytics, tools, popular tools in fact used for predictive analytics, a special use case of predictive analytics in e-commerce. This is what we are going to do in the demonstration that will be the later half of this class, right? So predictive analytics is nothing but you are trying to explore the historical data and trying to understand relationship between the data, right? So guys, do you know what is the difference between the predictive analytics and business intelligence? If I talk about business analytics and business intelligence, is there anyone who knows about it? What is the difference between business analytics and business intelligence? Right? Anyone who can tell me? Ganeshwar Rao, they both are same, right? They both are same. Prediction is for a longer duration, whereas forecasting, we consider them to be, for a shorter duration. Right? So general perspective is we usually forecast for a shorter duration, right? Not for a longer duration. Okay? Praveen is saying BI is showing data in an understandable way. Deepak Prasad is saying business intelligence is about insight of data. Right? So let me just quickly use my notepad here and let me draw three line here. Okay? One, two, and three. Okay? This is the present. Okay? This is where you are. This is the past, anything before present is certainly the past, right? So this is past, and anything which is towards this is the future, okay? Obviously, you will collect your data from past to present, right? So let's say you have data which is present in this duration, okay? This is your historical data. And if you are talking about BI, if you are talking about business intelligence, then you are using your historical data. I will say this data is historical data. And based on this data, you are creating some reports or dashboard, right? You are using this data. You can't see my screen. Can you guys see the MS Paint? Can you guys see the MS Paint? Yes, Praveen is not able to see it. Praveen, can you see this? I am sharing my screen and I see that a lot of participants can view that also. Okay, so when I'm talking about the age of BI, right? When I'm talking about age of BI, I am using the historical data, and from historical data, I am creating some reports and dashboard, right? This is where I called, I am in the age of BI. Okay, please excuse me for my bad handwriting. It doesn't work on MS Paint that well, okay? So this is the age of BI. The moment when you are trying to forecast, moment when you are trying to see the future from historical data, this is where we see that this is the area of business analytics or predictive analytics, right? So let's say you as a telecom vendor, you have the users data of your subscriber. You are just presenting the report. You are creating the report from the subscriber users data. That is what just the BI, okay? But based on the users data, you are trying to forecast what is going to be the users the next couple of months or next 6 months. That is actually the part of business analytics, okay? So I assume that at this point in time, we should be very clear what is BI and what is predictive analytics or what is business analytics, right? Am I clear with this? Any doubt till now? Any doubt till now? Okay, now I also want to understand that why do you think that analytics is getting popular these days? Why do you think analytics is getting popular these days? Quickly guys, Alka, Ambar, Amar, Asif, Ashutosh, why do you think analytics is getting so critical, so hyped, and everyone seems to be talking about analytics, right? Why is it? Vaskar, Sundar, Sridhar, data-driven decision, right? That's correct. But what do you think, what has gone changed in the last couple of years? Why suddenly, guys, we were collecting data in past also, but analytics was not that popular. Sanjog, right? We were collecting data in the past also, but analytics was not that popular in the past. What has gone changed? Data is increased leaps and bounds. Why, Sanjog? Why data is increased leaps and bounds? Suddenly you see a lot of people starting using data. Okay, so let me just take a simple example, right? What do you think, what was the cost of 1 terabyte equivalent memory in 1990? Guys, what do you think? What was the cost of 1 terabyte equivalent storage in 1990? Can somebody guess? Praveen is saying in lakhs. Deepak is saying 50K plus. I want you to guess. I don't have any right guess till now. Kaushik is saying in billions. Okay. Kaushik is saying in billions, 1 terabyte. Asif is saying millions of pound, okay? So let me tell you, in order to buy 1 terabyte equivalent storage in 1990, you need to shell out around $9 million. That was the cost of 1 terabyte hard disk in 1990, just 25 years back, okay? And now, what is the cost of 1 terabyte hard disk? How much money you need to spend in order to buy 1 TB? Less than $90, right? In less than $90, right? So what I'm trying to say with this example is that cost of storing data in last 25 years or last 20 years has gone down drastically from $9 million USD to just $90 or less than $90, right? So now organization can easily store the data which they could not 20 years back, right? Because of the expensive storage. They can easily store the data and hence they can run analytics on. Okay, the other example is just look back 10 years maybe in the year 2002 in order to buy a 512 MB processor. In order to, or let's say in order to buy a very ordinary processor, a very ordinary laptop, okay, what do you think? How much money do you need? How much money do you need? If you are trying to buy an ordinary storage or ordinary processing power computer in 2002, right? Compare that storage with today's smartphone, right? A 512 MB RAM, a 512 MB RAM desktop in 2002 was a luxury. That was a luxury during that time, okay? But now if you talk about the simplest smartphone, they are having, you know, more than a GB RAM in it, right? Just at the, you know, maybe 1/4 or, you know, 1/10 of the cost. So what I am trying to say, since the cost of storage has gone down, cost of processing data has also gone down drastically. And that is the reason which is fueling the more and more uses of data. Right? Are you all with me? This is where the actual boom is coming in the industry. Yeah, right? You have liberty where you can store data at a very cheaper cost. You can process data at a very cheaper cost. Then why not generate insight from this data? Okay? Fueled with the social media, you know, uses, fueled with the latest development of the technology like open source system, Hadoop and, you know, big data, all those things. Now since we are generating lots of data, we have tools, we have established some tools that can analyze that data and can get and generate insight for us. Okay, are you all with me? Are you all with me what I'm trying to explain with these examples? Yeah? Anyone who is having any conflict with this? So nobody will generate a technology or create a technology until there is a user for that technology. Big data came into the picture. Why? Because we can store a good amount of data now. Why? Because cost of storing data has gone down now. Okay? If somebody would have invented big data 20 years back, that would not have been a success. Right? All with me? All with me? Right? Now, what do you think? What are some of the popular use cases? Some of the popular use cases. Anyone who knows about the popular or very interesting use cases of data analytics? Somebody has heard about any interesting use cases? Anyone? Think about it. The practical interesting use cases, right? So we all know that big data analytics has been used in you know, what do you say, telecom and retail and banking and insurance, right? That's not so much interesting. Okay, let me give you some very interesting use cases of analytics, the application of analytics, right? One of the application is that Los Angeles Police Department, LAPD, they are using analytics in order to predict the crime even before they occur. What that department does, that department create the heat map on the map of Los Angeles, and they create the hotspot of crime, the popular area of crime, and accordingly they, you know, schedule their staffing, right? So even before the crime occur, that department is trying to predict the crime. Okay, how? Based on historical data. That is one of the interesting example. Another interesting example, you might have heard about it. So guys, who won the last football World Cup? Which country won the last football World Cup? Which one? Which company won the football World Cup in the last year? Or maybe, you know, the last football World Cup? Germany, right? Germany. How many of us knows that SAP. SAP helps. SAP was the 12th person for Germany in the World Cup. SAP used the analytics to help Germany team perform better than the other teams. If you will Google it, you will get a great article that SAP was the 12th person for Germany in the World Cup. If you Google it, you will get the interesting story related to it. Okay, SAP HANA. That's correct, Saikat. That's correct. Okay, that's another interesting use case of analytics in the gaming industry. Right? A very interesting use case that I came across related to analytics is that there is one medical company, what they are trying to do with the help of analytics, they are, what their end vision is that even before a person get a serious medical attack, right, before getting a serious medical attack, there would be an ambulance, you know, standing outside your gate. So they are trying to monitor the vital statistics of your body, not for you, but for entire population, and they are triggering an alarm when they see there is a, you know, critical complex mechanism is happening inside your body, right? So just imagine that anyone before getting heart attack, they have an ambulance already standing outside their home, right? So this is what the capability of analytics is, right? Smart cities is a buzzword now, right? Smart city is nothing without analytics. It is a pure use case of analytics, right? So these are some of the path-breaking uses of analytics where, you know, they are showing a real value to the business. Okay? All with me? All with me? Right? Asif is saying instead of ambulance, a mobile hospital makes sense. Yeah, that's all the uses of IoT and all those sort of things, Asif, right? So that's all Internet of Things and analytics together. Okay, so let us quickly run through the presentation and see, right? So we've discussed about what is predictive analytics. It is the analysis of data by using a statistical algorithm and machine learning technique to identify the likelihood of future outcome based on historical data. It's all about understanding better and better historical data, right? It's all about understanding the historical data in a better way, right? We will implement advanced statistical technique, right? We may be interested to do classification, right? We may be interested to do regression. We may be interested to do collaborative filtering, right, in order to generate insights from the data. Okay? Asif is saying, what is the percentage of accuracy in prediction? The percentage of accuracy depends upon what statistical algorithm you are applying into it, right? So you cannot say that 95 is the percentage of accuracy in prediction, right? So that completely vary from domain to domain, from application to application, Asif. Okay? Okay, percentage of accuracy will certainly vary depending upon, you know, application, depending upon domain, depending upon use cases. Okay, but we will pick up the data, we will use right mix of knowledge, we will use the right mix of statistical tool, and based on that we will generate insight from the data. Okay, this is what we will do in predictive analytics, right? So if you want to do really good on analytics, you need to have few mandatory skills. The first skill is the data management, right? With data management, I want to tell you that you should be able to prepare data, store data, and maintain data. So data management is the first skill that I want to see in any analyst. Second skill that I want to see is the programming skills, right? Programming, I consider it as the glue that connect data to analysis. You will use your programming skills to modify or to run algorithm on the data. Then comes the statistical skills, right? You need to at least run the basic statistics on the data, right? Like you may be interested to define what is the center point for the data, right? What is the distribution of the data, right? What is the spread of the data, right? What are the peak points in the data? So these are a few things that you can answer using statistics. And the final skill that I want to see in any analyst is the visualization. Visualization is nothing but visualization is a way using which you will communicate your data, right? You need to know how to communicate your data. So we talked about four skills: data management, we talked about programming, we talked about statistics, and we also talked about visualization, right? You need not to be very, very fluent in all of these four skills, but you should know about all four, right? That is what makes a good analyst or a good data scientist, right? You with me? So we talked about what are the skill set that is required here. Even a basic level of programming is fine, right? Even if you don't know programming, we will help you to understand and write basic program during the course, right? The way we have designed this course is to start with very basic of everything. It will start with very basic of visualization, very basic of statistics, very basic of programming, and then the data management. And of course, the one skill which sits on top of all of these is the domain knowledge, right? So let's say if you are an analyst for retail, right, you should have a better understanding about retail. And this is something that you will learn over a period of time. Nobody can give you domain knowledge in just, one class or two class, right? This is something which you will acquire over a period of time. So the business skill sits on top of all of these four skills. So this is the right mix of skill sets for a good analyst. Any confusion, guys? Any question till now? How much statistics knowledge required? I said we need basic statistical knowledge, right? We need not to know how a regression equation will be derived. What we need to know is where to use the regression equation, right? So what I'm trying to say, Kaushik, here is you need to know the application of statistics, not the derivation of statistics, right? You need not to know how this formula has been derived. What you need to know, when I should use this formula. Okay? Good, guys. Any question? Saiket, Deepak, any question that you have? Okay, the life cycle of predictive analytics starts from a question. The life cycle of analytics starts from a question. Okay, what is the business problem that I am going to answer with this data? Okay, let's say I am interested to improve the performance of marketing budget by 2%, right? This is what my problem is. So it starts with a problem. What is the problem definition that you have? Then what you will, so look at this. Identify and formulate problem. This is what the first step is. Then you will find out what all data is required in order to solve this problem. You will prepare that data. You will then explore the data, okay? You will do the transformation of all the data, and then you will pick up the right statistical model to solve this problem. Once you will build the model, you will validate the performance of the model, and then you will deploy this model into the production environment, and it's a continuous ongoing process. You will keep on evaluating the health of model every regular interval of time. Okay, so it always starts with the problem. If you are doing an analytics project without having a problem in hand, you will go nowhere. So it's always advisable to have a right set of questions that you need to answer from the data. This is what the right approach for analytics is, right? Right, the statistical model, how do we choose that? Saiket, you will learn about it, that which statistical model is fit for this data, right? Let's say you want to do the classification, right? You want to classify a record as a good record or bad record. To do this, we have a number of statistical model, okay, that you can use with this data. At times, you will solve the same problem using two or more models, and then you will compare the performance of various models, and you will pick one. Are you all with me? Let's say you want to classify a record, either a good or the bad record. We have a number of statistical models that you can use to solve the same problem, right? You will use multiple models to solve the same problem, and then you will compare the performance of various models and you will pick one. Okay? Okay, good. So this is about what it will it happen in real time. Sometime you do analytics in real time. Okay, let me take, so Asif's question is very valid. He is asking about will it happen in real time. So real time analytics is a separate stream altogether. Okay, let me take an example since Asif has given me this opportunity here. Let me take this example. Let's say you are interested to buy a laptop, okay, and to buy that laptop, you are entering into a shopping area, right? You are entering into a shopping area. There are a couple of storekeepers, they have some collaboration with your mobile vendor, and based on this collaboration of your mobile vendor, they know that you are interested to buy a laptop, and based on your location, they came to know that they are near to your market. Okay, they are near to their shop. Now what they can do at the real time, they can send you some offers. Okay, they can send you some offers. So just imagine that you are entering in a shopping market to buy a laptop and suddenly start getting a couple of SMS which are from the retailers which are there in the same market. Okay, with the discounts. Right, so this is something which needs to be in real time. The moment you are entering into the supermarket, you should get the offer then and there only. If they are sending you the offer after 2 hours or after 3 hours, it has got no meaning. Right? So Asif, one of the example of real time analytics. Okay, you getting it? So sending the right message to the right person at the right time. That is what the real-time analytics is, right? What are the method of model validation? Ashutosh, this question will be answered when we will take up the demonstration. Method of validation is usually when you have, let's say 100 record, what you will do, you will build the model on 70 record and remaining 30 record you will use to test the performance of model. Getting my point, Ashutosh? Excuse me, nice. Yeah? Good. Okay, let's go to the next slide. Application for predictive analytics. So these are the application. 47% cross-sell and upsell. If you are using a product, what is the next product that you might be interested in? This is what the cross-sell is. Upsell means how you can upgrade the current product that you are using it. Okay, so how you will come to know that if I am using a smartphone with two GB of RAM, should I be interested to upgrade it to 3 GB RAM or not? Okay, this is what the upselling is. Whereas the cross sell is, if I am using a smartphone, what should be the next product related to smartphone that a company should approach with me? Okay, approach to me. Then you have campaign management, customer acquisition, budgeting and forecasting. All of these are nothing but the application of predictive analytics. Percentage shows the percentage of adoption of all of these analytics in all of these areas. Okay, good. Real life example, we already talked a lot of real life examples, but there are few just at your slide you may be interested to read in. We have already discussed a very interesting use of analytics. Okay, there is no area where companies are collecting data and analytics cannot be used. Absolutely any area where company is collecting the data, analytics can certainly be used there. Okay, good. So some good example for you that you may want to read in real life examples. Okay, good. Now let us talk about the tools. The few predictive analytics tools are Python, RapidMiner, SAS, Me, and Minita. Okay, apart from this, there are a few more like SPSS, Weka, and few machine learning algorithms, okay, that you can use. But these are popular predictive analytics tools which are present in the market right now. Okay, good. So you can read through it. YR, it is one of the most widely used analytical software. It is open source. You can download it free. You can use it freely. A number of packages, a number of active users are there to help you. Okay, the most powerful, you know, analytical tool that is still growing. That is still growing. Okay, I have a question from Ganeshwara Rao on what criteria we consider the performance and what are the parameters to consider about the performance. Right. So performance, are you talking about performance of your predictive modeling or performance of tool? Yeah. So performance of a model is largely dependent upon the accuracy of the model. Okay, Ganesh? Performance of the model is largely dependent upon the accuracy of the model. If your model is doing well on training and the testing data, right, that means performance is good. Okay, so that largely dependent upon the accuracy of the model, Ganesh. Okay, good. So this is about uses of R. Let's go through it. Now you can see that the job trends, right, the jobs which are there in R and which are there in SAS, right, you can compare from this slide. Okay, the demand of professionals, those who know R well, is growing, and it's growing rapidly. Every organization which are trying to start their analytics, they are focusing heavily on R, right? Any question, guys? Any questions so far? Are we going good? And the popular comparison of R versus Python. Both are open source. R was specifically designed for data analysis, where Python can do a lot many other works apart from data analysis. The user base of R as a statistics language is gigantic, right? There are a lot of active users, those who are doing researches. There are a number of R packages that are getting published every day. So R is having a huge, gigantic space of users, right? Whereas Python is not, you know, having that liberty in that area. R has more advanced statistical functionality than Python. The visualization of R are superior than Python, and the better cross-platform compatibility is what R offers than Python. So here are a few points if you want to compare R with Python. Okay? Why there is a drop in R in Gen 11, I have no clue, Asif. I have no clue why there was a drop in Gen 2011. What I know right now is that there is a dearth of professional, those who knows R well, right? Initially, the learning curve of R may be quite steep, but later on, you will enjoy the graphics, the visualization, which are available in R, right? There are number of active users which are present in order to help you. Okay? Okay? Right, so Ganesh, right. So what the question that you are trying to ask is sensitivity, specificity, and performance, right? They majorly talk about accuracy. I am not going in that detail related to the model building, right? Because most of the person, those who are in the class, are very, very new to analytics. So I'm not going in these details of the term like sensitivity, specificity, and performance. Certainly, all of these things will be discussed in detail when we talk about the respective models. Okay, right? Sudhir is saying if a person knows Python programming already, then learning R is easy. I will say if you know any programming language, learning R would be easy. Right? If you know any programming language, learning R would be easy. Right? Okay, even if you don't know any programming language, we will help you to learn R from very basic, right? This is what our commitment is. Okay, good. Now is the time when we should take a use case, right? Just give me 1 minute, guys. Okay, now let me take a use case where we will use the predictive analytics for e-commerce, right? As an e-commerce company, your major pain points, there are two major pain points for any e-commerce company, is that who will revisit my website in next couple of days? This is one of the pain point. And the next point is who are likely to buy the product, right? Who will revisit the website in next couple of days? And who are likely to buy the product from my website? These are the two major concerns for any e-commerce company. And in order to do this, in order to solve this problem, we have collected some data which is in this format, okay? Let me just show you, right? We have collected the data in this format, like visitor ID, visitor type, visit count, landing page, exit page, average time spent on website, page views, unique page views, days since last visit, and the median, right? So how did you collect all of this data? There is an API called R Google Analytics. There is an API called R Google Analytics. Using this API, you can collect all of this data related to your web page, right? Related to your web page, you can collect all of this data, right? Now, let me show you this data in R. Just give me 1 minute. Let me just show you this data. Okay, so the screen that you are seeing on your screen is the R Studio. This is the most popular R GUI which is available now. Okay, again, this is open source. You can download it freely. In this GUI, I see four panel. The panel which is on the left hand top is the source panel. This is the place where you will write your commands. The panel which is just at the below of the left hand top section, the console panel. And this is the panel where your command will get executed. The right-hand top panel is the place, the right-hand top panel, that is the environment or the history panel. This is the place where you will see the variable that are going to create during the execution of program. And the right-hand bottom panel is the place where you will see your plot, your visualization, your files, and etc. Okay? So what I am going to do, I am not going to explain you the syntax as such, because that is not what the intention of this demonstration is. What I want to show you that how you can perform analysis on e-commerce data using R. Right? So guys, let me just load the data. Let's say this is the command. I have collected all of the data in data.csv file, the data that I was talking about, like visitor ID, visitor type, landing page, exit page, page depth, and so on. I have collected all of this data in a CSV file called data.csv, and let me load it in R. Just run this command and look at it. I have around 12458 observations and 11 variables. Dimension, medium, landing page, path, exit page, path. All of this data has been collected using Google Analytics API. Okay? Using Google Analytics API, I have collected this data. Okay, and so I have this data now, right? Now, if I want to do predictive analytics on this data, the first objective, as I talked about in the life cycle, is to frame the right question. What is the right question for you? Okay, so in this case, my question is that I want to identify the revisit of user in next couple of days. I want to identify the revisit of the user in next couple of days. This is what my objective is, right? So we are interested into predicting the revisit of user, okay? And for that, we need to create a prediction object. What is going to be the prediction object? We need to do that, okay? And we will create the prediction object in a while from now, okay? So are you guys getting it? The first step is to identify the problem. My problem is that I want to know that who all visitors are going to revisit my website in the next couple of days. This is what my problem is. To solve this problem, I have collected the data from the website using Google Analytics. The data is in front of you. And now, what we need to do, based on the information of previous visit of user, we want to predict the probability score of revisit in next few days of user. Okay? So this is the data that you are seeing here is nothing but the session level information of previous visit. Okay? These are the session level information of previous visit. Okay, now guys, let us go back to the script here, and I am with this step, so look at this. My first column name is what? Dimension 1. I want to change this column name. So in order to change this column name, I will run this command. I want to give the name visitor ID to this column. Let's run this and look at the data here. So this is now visitor ID. I just changed the column name, which was not correct from the data, and then I am just cleaning some data, right? I am just cleaning data. So substituting some values here and cleaning some data. So just now you can ignore these steps here. My data is clean. I have some base point set up here. Look at this. So this is what I changed here. Okay? No need to worry about it, guys. These are just the data cleaning steps. The step which is important for you to know here is that I need to define that what is a revisit. I need to define the definition of revisit. So what I am saying, the definition of revisit in this case is that if any user who has logged in more than one time and the days since last session is less than 10. Okay? Okay, so look at this. I have this formula set up here. Data, if session count, that means if person has logged in more than one time and the days since last session is less than 10, I will consider that as a revisit. If anyone who is visiting my website in less than 10 days and visiting more than one, I will categorize that person as a revisited person. This is what the definition of revisit for me. Okay? So let me create this. Right now, there is no column for revisit. Look at this. I have visitor ID, medium, landing path page, exit path page, and so on. But I have no column for revisit. And revisit is going to be my target variable. I am creating that variable here. Look at this. If I run this command, I'll have a variable revisit right at the end of this data here. Look at this. Revisit 0 means this person has not made a purchase in last 10 days and has not visited my website. Look at this. 1 means this person has visited more than once my website and has done it in less than 10 days. So this is a revisit. Okay? This is my target or response variable. The revisit is my target or response variable. Okay? Now, since visitor ID is not an important column, this is not an important column. I am dropping this column. How to drop this column? Using this command. Look at this. The visitor ID will not be here. Okay. Now, as I said, this is my entire data. 1, 2, 4, 5, 8 observation. This is my entire data. In order to build my model, I will divide my data into two parts. Training data and testing data. Training data, I will keep 80% of the data. With training data, I will build my model, and remaining 20% of the data, which is the test data, I will keep that data to check the performance of my model, right? So with this command, I am creating my training data set and testing data set, okay? Look at this train data and test data. If I want to see how many rows that I have in train data, I can do that. I can say n row train data. There are 9966 rows in training data. And if I want to see what is in the test data, there are 2492 rows in the test data. So entire data set I have divided into two parts. 9966 rows I will use to train my data, and 2492 rows I will use to test my data. Okay, so I will build my data on the training data. I will build my model on training data and I will test it on the test data. Now, since this is a problem where my dependent variable is binary. My dependent variable can have only two values. Okay. Why we split the data as train? Gonna say, Ganeshwar, you got the answer of this question? Asif and Ganesh, you got the answer? Okay. So Asif, we will divide the data into training and testing, because training data I will use to build the model, right? How would I come to know that model that I have built is accurate or not? There could be a chance that model is doing good on a particular set of data, right? There could be a good chance that model is doing good on a particular set of data, right? In order to check the performance of the model on the unseen data. So testing data will not be exposed to the model until the model is finalized. Once you will finalize the model, you will plug in this data and you will check the performance of the model, that whether my model is doing correct or not. So testing data, guys, Asif and Ganeshwar, you can think of it as the data that has not been presented to the model in the past. This is a new data. This is going to be the future data. Getting my point? Right? 50-50 split is not recommended. Okay? You need a good amount of data to build model. That is why 80% or 70%. So you can use 80-20, 70-30, 60-40. Right? Any combination that you can use. But you should have a good amount of data to build the model. Right? Now, I am using a model called logistic regression. A lot of you may not know about this model, but right now just think of it that this is the model which will give you the probability, which will give you the probability of revisit. In this model, I will specify my target variable. This is my target variable, and all of these variables are my independent variable. That means session count, sessions, page views, unique page views, session duration, all of these variables can influence the revisit. Okay, so this is the model that I'm using to get the probability of revisit. GLM is the command that will invoke the logistic regression model. Okay, GLM stands for generalized linear model. All of these things is certainly not the scope of this demo, okay, but just good to know. We will explain all of these things in the class. Okay, let's run this command here. Okay, now look at this. I built this model on the train data. Notice it, guys. This is the training data. I built the model on training data set, right? Now, I will use the prediction command, the predict command, and I will say test data, okay? I will say test data, right? This is the data which I have not exposed to the model, okay? This is the data about which model doesn't know anything, right? Now, I will do the prediction on this data using predict function. Let's run this command here. Okay, if you will take a look at this here, test predict probability here, you will have a probability, right? All of these numbers are nothing but the probability. So probability for record 124456 is 0.07. Okay, probability for this record is 0.007 again. Okay, 0.07 again. Okay, let us combine this probability with our testing data set. using cbind function. And let us take a look at the test data set one here. Now, these are the records which is the part of testing data set, and at very end you will see a probability. That means that the probability that this person will revisit website is 0.27. Okay? The probability, let me pick up a good look at this. The probability that this person will visit website is almost 1. Right? Similarly, we have probability associated with each of the records here. Okay? You getting this? Look at this. For this person, probability is around 60% that this person will visit my website. Okay. Okay? You can also round off, since these probabilities are here, you can say that if probability is less than 0.5, the person will not visit. If probability is greater than 0.5, you can say person will visit. And this is what we are going to do in next set of command. We are rounding off the probability here with the round function. And again, we are binding this probability with our test data. Let's run this and take a look at the test data now. Now, you have the actual number. This person will visit, will not visit, this person will visit, right? So, with this example, for an e-commerce website, based on a number of parameter like session count, days since last visit, right, and number of such parameters, unique page views, we predicted that what is the chance that a new user or a person will revisit your website. Okay, so based on this, how can R be used for analyzing data in a manager perspective? It is Harsha. This is nothing like from the manager perspective, that R can be used if you have data, right? Regarding manager perspective, if you will be more specific that what area you want to use R in, I might help you. Okay, but as such, manager perspective, there is nothing like it. Okay, have we used only test data or test plus train now? Okay, so Asif, let me show you here. For prediction, just a minute, for prediction, I used test data. Look at this. This is the command for prediction. I use test data. Whereas to build model, I use train data. Okay. In supply chain, Sudhir, we can use R. Okay. In supply chain, we can use R. Okay, for prediction you don't need full data, see. For prediction you just need the data which model has not seen in the past. Okay, obviously you will predict for the data about which you don't have any idea. Okay, guys, I am opening the class for the questions that you have. See, so think of it that test data never existed. Think of it that there was no probability, there was no outcome associated with the test data, right? This is the new data. You will build the model on the data and you will test the performance of the model which the model has not seen in the past. Okay? You don't need complete data to do the prediction. Why you would like to do prediction? You already have the probability, you already have the revisit count for your existing data set, Asif, right? You already have the revisit count for your existing data. Why you need to do prediction for that? You will do prediction about the data in which you don't have the revisit count. Okay? Okay, guys, I am opening the class for the question and answers. Rajesh, Ravi, Shweta, Kaushik, Harsha, question and answers please. I hope you guys are able to understand about the basic of how we can do model building in R. This is just a very, very quick demonstration of use of predictive analytics use in R, right? Okay, steps in developing a model: problem definition, data preparation, data exploration, model selection, model building, model validation, model deployment, and continuous tracking. Ashutosh. Related to course cost, related to the course timing, please drop a mail to support@edureka.co. Right. Course duration, I believe it's six week. Okay. I want to, as a product manager, if I want to analyze the market data using visualization, how can I do it? Yes, you can do that in R, right? It would be difficult for me to explain it in the demo class, Harsha, but visualization using market data, you can certainly do with R. Okay. SN Bhaskar, Sundar, any question from you? Sudhir, Sanjog, Ravi. Algorithms are the algorithms are not tied to any domain. They are not tied to. I am not very sure if there are few algorithms which are specific to some domain, but I have not seen any algorithm which is specific to any domain. Okay, you can very well use algorithm in retail, the same algorithm in telecom and in other business areas also. Yes, you will have the recorded videos if you will miss the classes, Harsha. Yes, you will have that. Yes, R can be used for lean projects. That's correct, Sridhar. We can use that. Praveen, drop a mail to support. They will share the more details about the course. Same thing is also present in our website. You can check that. Yeah. Madhur, any question from you? Harsha, Gautam, Dinesh, Deepak Prasad, Asif, Amar Khambre. R can be connected to practically any data source. R can be connected using Excel, text file, Facebook, Twitter, HDFS, NoSQL databases, Oracle, RDBMS, practically any data source. Even SAS, SPSS, you can connect R directly with those sources. Yeah, Deepak. R GUI servers serves the same purpose as R Studio. This is R Studio, Harsha. This is R Studio, one of the GUI that is in front of you. Okay, R GUI, R Studio, R Commander, Rattle, whatever you use, basically they use the same core R functionality. Okay. Do we use unstructured data for predictions? Yes, we do. We do use unstructured data for predictions. Okay, R is capable of doing that. Okay, thanks, Harsha. Thank you for attending this session. After learning R to become domain expert by applying R is possible without guidance. That, Sudhir, that completely dependent upon the effort that you are putting in, right? We will give you the right examples from various domain. We will explain you R from very basic, and we are very hopeful that if you will follow the tight schedule of Edureka, you will be able to have a good understanding of R. Okay. Yes, Kaushik, it will help you. It will help to any experience group. I see people having more than 20 years of experience and still learning R. Okay, started learning R, in fact. Okay. Various profile, right? I see people from project management, from architect, and from various profiles. Okay, from marketing, yeah, I see a lot of people. Course, will the technique of picking an algorithm? Yes, correct, Ashutosh. We will tell you how to pick right technique algorithm. Okay, Praveen, the question that how we are different from other online courses will be answered by the support team. Okay. Mining engineer, I need to identify which area to be explored for gold mining. That's an interesting area, Ashutosh, right? That's an interesting area. Okay. the analytics can be used there. No need to buy any textbooks with here. No need to buy any textbook. Okay. Okay, any more questions, guys? If anyone's question is not answered, please repost it here. Okay, we have a couple of minutes left. I am not seeing any questions. So guys, thank you so much for attending this session. If you have any more questions, please drop a mail to support team. And I hope you enjoyed it. And see you. Bye-bye, guys, and have a great time. Thanks for your time. Yeah. Thank you, guys.